So, Ms. Dunn, deputies, Mr. Finn, Ms. Gavin, teaching colleagues, and those joining our virtually, with most of all, the bright students of 2020. I would like to welcome you all here this afternoon to this very special transition year celebration ceremony. It is very different to any other TY celebration we had in the past, thanks to the coronavirus COVID-19. In 2020, we began the transition year program in September 2019. We have none of us back there. This event should have taken place last May on a grand scale, on a lovely summer's evening. And it's all the glitz and glam. But we're lucky to be able to host it here today, even though it's on a much smaller scale. As the great philosopher Epictetus once stated, it is not what happens to you, but how you react that matters. As a TY group, you certainly reacted very well to the situation you found yourselves in at the end of the academic year. Many of you completed your graduate under strange circumstances. Some students completed their CDL, even though there was major difficulties in trying to access that. A very impressive yearbook was produced, and copies were ordered and distributed. As a new group, you grasped all the opportunities, and shortly you will be entertained by a PowerPoint with all of your happy memories. Students, this is a very important time in your lives. Be kind to yourselves, be kind to others, and take extra care to keep yourselves and your family safe. Be proactive. Enjoy the outdoors each day. Exercise is the key to physical and mental health. Be it your favorite team sport, just a long walk, or a training session. Be grateful for the small and simple things in life, things that are most important. And I think we have learned a lot over the last 6 months about what is really important in our lives. Begin all tasks by taking baby steps. Set meaningful and manageable goals. And in this way, you will not be overwhelmed. I would like to take this opportunity to thank my team of class teachers, Ms. McRae, Mr. Lynch, Ms. Murphy, and Ms. Robin, for all their hard work throughout the year. To Mr. King, the program coordinator, for his IT detail, and his great organization skills. And the rest of the TY core group, Mr. Foster, Ms. Lancaster, and Ms. Media, for their constant support. But I'd also like to say a word of thanks to Mr. Bowen, who was my assistant last year, and has moved on with you now in Tweedfield. Mrs. Dunn, Mr. Finn, and Ms. Gavin, the management team here at the Colosh Freedom, are always a great support to everything we do in transition year. A team of students, teachers, and caretaking staff made a great work here yesterday morning in organizing the gym for this celebration ceremony. It was no mean task to get everything ready in time, so I would really like to thank them for everything that they did. Parents and guardians, we are very grateful to you for giving your sons and daughters the great opportunity of participating in the TY program. You should be really proud of them. They have achieved so much. The administration and office staff are always so helpful when anything needs to be done or organized in relation to this and what have you. So again, I would like to extend my kind of view to them. And our county staff are going to produce some nice treats at the end of the ceremony. And so we'd like to thank them in looking forward to that. And now it only remains for me, students, to wish you your transition year class 2020 every success in the senior cycle and joy and happiness in your lives. Thank you.
Martin, I think you can echo by the law or cost there, or thanks, appreciation, everyone who's involved in this call, today's event. Now, so our first item we'll go to on the awards for me is our mini company. Now, mini company, as you know, we have a great tradition of participation in the Input Ireland Monthly Awards program every year. The past 2020 was no different, and added very much to our culture of success in this program. Over 40 meetings took part in our internal school competition, and we'd particularly like to thank our judges, Ian Joe, Matt Wood, and William Rossmark from Centre, who put a lot of time and effort into meeting each of the mini companies, interviewing the mini companies, and selecting five companies to go forward to our competitive finals. And indeed, from the four Ash, four Beach, four Arbogens, we had one mini company represented at the competitive in much more finals, and I'm going to ask Miss Lee now to present an award to the company Yellow Brick Codes, who developed QR codes to identify people's belongings. And the members of that group were Adam Carroll, Max Maroney, Kieran O'Sullivan, and Anna Talley for Ash. So well done to our board. Now we're going to move on to the presentation of your certificates for portfolios. And in your portfolios, students will receive a myriad of certs for various marketing that you participate in throughout the year, from items such as drama, hill walking, and ECL, to main both at a few. And we're going to ask Mr. Green now to come up to present the certificates to the students in for Ash. So I will call you up to your four at a time, please. And then we will shake hands to speak with the guidelines. So, our first group of students for Ash are Ali Barnes, Kira Burke, Adam Carroll, Emma Cullinan, and Rachel Garcia. Our second group are Lara Dyke, Sophie Dover, Lee Doyle, Evan Doyle, and Fiona Furlong. Abby Goodwin, Ellie Pack, Owen Hederman, Anna Lawler, and Sija Hedra. Max Maroney, Sean Mahal, Molly Monroe, Katie Nolan, and Emo Ryan. Leanne O'Connor, Anna Sullivan, Ben O'Connor, Patrick Carter, and Kieran O'Sullivan. Thank you. Commissioner and Senior Lori. Victoria Drinkle, Edgar Forsyth, Donna Gasper, Shay Devine, and Anna Rubin. Is Nance, Dana Hughes, Laura Piper, Dominic Yannizak. Lucy Campbell, Sergio Penny, Kieran Edward Kinsla, Jesse Kinsla, and Ava Lancaster. Maeve Walls, Keith Mulligan, Ariana Rohr, Claire O'Toole, David Quinn.
And there was such an electric energy in the room. Like, everyone was so excited to get into the new year and everything. It was such an exciting experience to have. And of course, some of our students have participated in the Drunken Shore. And I think it's worth mentioning how legitimately, like, cool and creative a lot of the things that were before. And, like, can we all take a minute to just appreciate the sheer effort and creativity? And the models, like, honestly, all of it was just incredible. We had our trip to the Adventure Center. That was genuinely such a fun day. We, you know, we had all kinds of different things to do. We did canoeing, rock climbing, zip lining, archery. It was such a fun way to kick off the year and sort of get us comfortable with what we'd be doing. And I will never forget the shock and terror of capsizing my little canoe and being plunged into freezing water because I thought standing up on it was a good idea. Transition to that set. All the musical. I may not have a small part in this. As you can see, the we looking delightfully heterosexual. They're great. It's no really things are also okay, to be honest. But no, on a real anyone who is involved in the musical can agree that it was such an insanely fulfilling and exciting experience. And I had such a massive amount of fun doing it. It was genuinely the best class I've ever been to part of. And honestly, you know, yelling on stage like that really did prepare me to yell on stage like this today. So, you know, there's a lot of good to come into it. I do believe it's not a lot of weight now, to be honest. Definitely a highlight. Speaking of highlights, too, I think. Also known as the most stressful experience of my entire life. It was really engaging and challenging, and I think it definitely put us all up skills in marketing, entrepreneurship, all kinds of real world skills that we're going to need one day. And it definitely actually got to make my science and pretty Instagram pages. So it's a win for everyone. Oh, this was YSR. We had, I believe, two wonderful and important projects. One was focused around male breast cancer, and I will actually not to make this about me again, the leader of the second group, which was focused around supporting LGBT plus people coming out. And I think everyone involved did some really important advocacy in education. It was really, really nice to just feel like we were making a change in the world. And then, of course, we all had our different Tuesday activities this year, including, I'm sorry, doing this, and we had the walking gym, tennis, taekwondo, going to the Orchard Center, and even swimming. I think it was a really, really great way to unwind and be lost and see on what is left all days of the worst day of the week. And then, oh yeah, we have a road safety trip. I'm sure you all remember we all had road safety last year. And I think about half of you actually got to go on a trip and, you know, drive real cars like big boys and girls. It taught us a lot about, you know, navigating real world situations and passer carry tests and all kinds of really important things. This was the ESS trip. Once again, about half a year got to go to, you know, a real life thing. You should remember going places. I don't. See, real life examples of, you know, sunshine drift and other cool natural occurrences in our world. It's pretty exciting. Beach weather looks fantastic. All the trips are won for XP on its open day. This was such a fun day and a really, really great way to experience, you know, college courses and the structure of that kind of life and all the different facilities there were and the different lectures to sit in on. And hey, we got to ride on a bus and this day still looks up. Oh, and this is possibly my favorite part of PowerPoint, okay? This is just a few pictures of our little blow up over the years. This is evil. But if you don't like what you see, you can direct all of your complaints to one of the I have nothing to do with the name of this presentation. Don't shoot the messenger. Can you guys believe that we were actually this terrible? That is insane to me. I believe there is documentation of people looking like that. And then, you know, of course, we move on to some more recent pictures of us, you know, looking cute and having fun, and we're both just enjoying our transition year. And, you know, there you go. We all look great. You all look great, okay? Don't complain. Oh, jeez, I'm getting the junior server notes. I very nearly threw up that day. It was super fun for me. But overall, I was just happy to have my grades in my hands finally after such a long wait. And I think, in general, it sort of was like a repeat of the induction day, because the vibes and the energy were just so, like, big and good, and I just kind of really missed that energy. Everyone was just kind of happy to be there. And look, I know as well as you do that hard, you know, you possibly didn't go exactly as planned, but I think we all really threw ourselves into everything and gave it a go, and probably looked pretty sort of doing it, but we learned, and we had fun, and that's what matters. So, like, fair for us. Thank you so much. Here's your TY class of 2020.
So that unique perspective on the stage, that is not a friend of the Now, we are going to move on now to our President's Award, the Oshka Awards, and ask the students now again to come up and present this. Thanks again to the students, Ms. Martin, for being this role here. And just a couple of words on the Oshka Awards. The Oshka Award is awarded by the President's Department, who, you know, people who participate in activities for an hour a week or a couple of weeks. For two activities and an hour a week for 26 weeks for their program. So, the personal skills, for example, learning a new language or new instrument or craft, physical recreation, which can be team sports, doing cycling, community bonding, which will be visiting nursing home, helping a little girl with community care, charter shops and bike accounts, and then the fourth one was the adventure journey. It was an extremely difficult year, of course, for casting and trying to complete the challenges due to our restrictions. But the Gosh Guide was used to change the challenges and suit the stages that they faced. So their adventure journey was based by the approach in the end, and that was also suited to complete. So we have some other more than mentioned volunteers. We are going to call our four Ash and our Jimmy's first. And they are Anna Arms, Kira Burr, Anna Carroll, and Pulida. Lucy Ametta, Paul Hall, Eva Roy, you're also Anna Carroll. So we are the policy for our four Ash students. For each of the students from the 10th day, we have Tommy Burn, Peter Burn, David Golden. Taylor Hughes, Jessica Hinsett, and Claire O'Connor. So welcome to our four Beach students and a round of applause for us all this evening. Well, this is the start of our EYU class again, and this time we have the track group and lead with a set of Chiefs. So we have awards for students in 4 Ash and 4 Beach. which was directed by Gina Riley, Alan Carter, and Keane Walsh.
Now, we're going to move on to
Arena Awards. Now, the Carbon Hill Arena Awards recognize a lot of the academic work that the students have done throughout the year. And we know a lot of students happen at or inside and outside the classroom. In your different modules, we feel it's very important to recognize academic achievements for your students also. With over 70% of the timetable dedicated to academic subjects, we want to be a lot of work and understand your group state as you move into the future. So, the Department of Arena awards for 4-R will be shared with Alan Carroll and Kieran Russell.
You've missed out on that, and she was adamant that something special would happen for you, as was Mr. King. So I would like you to give them a big round of applause. And again, by thinking about what we do every day and how we are every day in the Rotorua, the mission statement really stood out for me, and I'm sure it did for you and your people as well throughout the year. Caring, challenging, and achieving together. Let's just take caring. You have cared for each other from the get-go. You have all grown up and appreciated what each other can offer. And I can see that here today as you received your prizes and as you presented and did all of those kinds of things. Challenging, well, this year was challenging for sure. It was challenging for you young people, because it's very hard at your age to accept that something like this could happen. It's hard enough for us, but as has been said, when we started in August, little did we know that in March things would have turned head over heels and gone inside out. But you've taken the challenge, you've accepted it, you've shown resilience beyond your years, and for that we're really, really proud. Achieving together, we've heard, we've seen, you've achieved so much this year. And I think what Mrs. Byrne said, it's not what happens, but how you react. And I would have to say, we are particularly proud of how you react, how you kept going, even though things were difficult. I want to congratulate each and every one of you. I think there are musicians here as well who are joining us today. But it's now how you move forward. And I know you will move forward. It is different in your classes now as well, but you will move forward and you will achieve together. Perhaps in a different way, but you will achieve and do very well. I received an email this morning from a parent of a student who left a number of years ago. And while maybe it's more for Leaving Cert, I do want to read it out to you, and I think it will help us all to move forward. So, dear Mrs. Stone, this is a student who sat at Linty Wyman really well, sat at the insert, and I remember the day so well. She was 5 points short of the course she wanted. She stopped over missing UCD by 5 points. She could have easily stayed at home. I literally had to push her to go and take bioscience. She stopped the day I left her in Dublin. We often talk about it now. But
which he did for 2 years from level 7 to 8 in bioscience, then level 8 in molecular mechanisms of disease. And now she's doing her master's in Trinity in immunology, and she's talking about doing a second master's before her 4-year doctorate. She's absolutely amazing. Being pulled out this year in the middle of her lab work for her thesis was dreadful, but she managed to get through. How I wish the students this year could just see 4 or 5 years down the road and know with persistence anything is possible. That they will be okay. That they can find a way if they work hard. It may take a little longer, but it can be done. It's so hard for them, and at such a young age, where they are not old enough yet to know that things pan out if you hold in there. And I think for us all, that's exactly, they do pan out, we hold in there, and we give everything our very, very best. And I know you have a lot of that as you have in the past. We wish you all the best, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ms. Hope. Before we finish off with our final music piece, I apologize and go back and backtrack you a bit for our Japanese awards. I left out one group of students who participated in our Japanese module and we participated in the competition. And they were Reader Award, Ava Lancaster, and Ava Hughes. If you want to give them a little award for this award, please. Thank you. Now we have our final piece of music from the whole core of our musicians. And again, huge thanks to Ms. Lynch, Mr. Callan, and Mr. McHugh. And we'll all get a part of this time and then we'll see us our additional support over again. Thank you.